I'd like to take a brief moment and just really congratulate Peyton Manning for a great, great career. Truly a legend, has meant so much to this great institution, the state of Tennessee, Knoxville, everything. And, you know, I value our friendship, and I know today is a very, very special day for him, and just wanted to let him know that we're thinking about him, our players are thinking about him, and he truly is a legend, and we're proud to call him a Vol for life. In terms of Team 120, we've had a very, very productive offseason. To me, this is the most exciting time of the year. You know, it's all about reinventing yourself, establishing your identity as a football team. It's the first time that Team 120 takes the field. And really, again, learning situational football, creating habits. We've spoken all offseason that, you know, in the last 18 games, we're 13-5 as a football program. And those five losses have come from a combined total of 25 points. So we're searching for those 25 points in everything that we do, in everything. And those 25 points are everywhere, but they're the hardest 25 points to score. So everything is about improvement, and it's everyone taking own self-determination for their own individual improvement. And as we all know, when you improve individually, you improve collectively as a football team. You know, it's all about time spent versus value received. We have to make sure that we make the most of it. As you all know, we'll practice today, we'll practice Tuesday, we'll practice Thursday, and then we go on spring break. And it's gonna be how do we handle the installations, retention of information when we come back from spring break. And I think that will tell us again a little bit of the maturity of our football team. This offseason has all been about leadership as well. I think we have some individuals that really are asserting themselves as team leaders, as program leaders for Team 120. And it's really putting our players in the channel of success every day. And that channel of success comes from fundamentals, fundamental improvement. Coach Shoup talks about it all the time, techniques over tactics with everything that we're doing. And we're gonna start from ground zero. It's like football 101 with blocking, tackling, running the football, catching the football, starting from ground zero. We have to have focus, concentration, and everything that we do. We're talking about contesting. This is a conference that everything is contested. Nothing in this conference goes uncontested. So contesting every practice, every class, every meeting, making sure that we're better for it each and every day. In terms of position changes, we'll have three individuals go through different positions. The first one is Austin Smith. Austin will move from linebacker to defensive end. Micah Abernathy will move from corner to safety and also continue to compete at the nickel position. And then Jason Kroom will move from receiver to tight end. All three individuals have done a tremendous job this offseason, really embracing that. And I know we're looking forward as coaches to really seeing them on the field with their different respective positions. In terms of players out for the spring, I'm not going to get into specifics of the injuries, but we'll have 11 players out. We didn't tell Coach Shoup this when we hired him, but he may have to play a little defensive line this spring. We have five defensive linemen out. Derek Barnett, Shai Tuttle, Kendall Vickers, Kyle Phillips, and Andrew Butcher. Also, Jayshon Robertson and Chance Hall in the offensive line, and then Evan Berry, Josh Malone, Joe Stockstill, and Joe Young will be out this spring. So we're going to really focus on getting them back. We should have all these individuals back by June when we start our summer phase of our football program. And I know these players are still going to work hard with the mental effort, mental intensity that it takes. And they'll spend a lot of time while practice is going on in the training room, but also in the weight room, doing the things that they can do to make themselves a better football player. And we're anxious to see what he can do. I know it's been a long process for him. He's still nagged a little bit by a hamstring issue, so I don't know how much he'll actually be full go today. But he's worked exceptionally hard in the training room and getting himself back. And we really need him for all these practices for his individual improvement. And, you know, I don't want to speak for Coach DeBoer, but really, you know, seeing what he can do and how he fits into the offensive scheme of things. Well, you know, some just by sheer stature and size, they won't be able to be moved inside. But in terms of Austin Smith, continues to grow and get bigger. I believe he's over 250 plus pounds right now. And he has an explosiveness off the edge. He's done a great job of really using the hand tactics and the different techniques through skill development that are associated with that position. And we all know that he can run. He's very, very physical. He's very explosive. So I think that's just going to add to the overall depth, the overall component of the defensive end position. And then you look at some individuals that we had the luxury of redshirting, starting with Daryl Taylor. Can't wait to see him. He has had as good of an offseason as any player in our football program. He's added the size, the stature, and I know he's looking forward to playing football.
And we all are well aware of what Derek Barnett can do. We're aware of what some of these other guys can do. But I'm really excited to see Daryl Taylor and Austin Smith this spring. Mixon's another guy at defensive end we're excited about as well. You know, we've seen Vereen, we've seen LaTroy Lewis. As far as moving a guy inside, it's funny, you know, you're always trying to be creative on passing downs, whether it's second and long, third and long, and we've used creative ways of getting three DNs in the game, whether it was, you know, not in the spring, but in the fall, putting Derek Barnett at a three technique, finding a mismatch, things like that. So, you know, when the situation arises this spring, we'll give those guys an opportunity to rush from the inside as well.
You know, Shy continues to progress. He just had the screws taken out from the second surgery on his foot. So he'll continue to progress. He will, you know, it's really day by day by him and how the body heals. You know, we're hoping maybe by early July, late June. That's kind of the target date, but we'll know probably every 2 or 3 weeks on how he's progressing. But I've been very proud of him because he's really kept his demeanor up. He's been very positive. He's really focused on the mental part of his game, and then he's really focused on developing his upper body. And, you know, it's hard for a young man, you know, first year in the program and suffers that type of injury that he's had and the recovery that's associated with that injury. And he's handled it remarkably well, and I think his teammates have done a good job around him.
Well, we've broken down our entire offense, and we looked at different types of improvement that we need to make, and we need to improve all facets of offense. And to answer your question, we've got to improve our passing game at all positions. That starts with protection. We've got to do a better job of being firm inside and protecting the edges with the tackles. And we've got to be more accurate with our throw game. Receivers, they got to work on releases, and they've really been working in hard and skill development on the breaking point. That's another aspect we've got to get better at. Running backs, they want to get better at pass pro. So the entire, all parts of our offense have to get better. But to answer your question, we've broken it down by position. We've broken it down by the entire unit. And those are the things we're going to really strive at getting better at this spring.
I do. I've never done that before, but I'm kind of excited about it. And Coach used the phrase before, techniques over tactics. And we've really kind of, it's been exciting to me to work with Coach DeBoard because we've really worked together. Hey, this is what we need on defense. Hey, this is what we need on offense. Working together as a staff has been kind of, you know, a real refreshing thing for me. So we've divided in the teaching to kind of treat this like a mini camp, so to speak. The first 2 days are non-padded, as you know, anyway. So teaching the fundamentals, teaching the techniques, as Coach Jones put, football 101, taking a break, digesting from there, and then building as we progress here, getting to, you know, the week after spring break, then the week after that, then the week after that, then finally the orange-white game. So this progression is exciting to me. And for me personally, what I want to get done is I want to evaluate our personnel, find out what the skill set is of each player, you know, find out who our contributors can be, who's our best 11, who's our next best 11, identify their strengths and put those players in a position that they can be successful and help Team 120.
All right, Corte Sapp, yes, he was able to gain the red shirt. And a lot of times that doesn't have to be put in for a while, so we have plenty of time, but I've been told that he will be granted that. So we'll see, but I've been told that. In terms of Dave Lawson, Dave Lawson is in charge of our entire strength and conditioning program as an athletic department. He still remains in that role. Mike Sershon is doing a little bit more of the day-to-day you know, handles of the football program in and of itself, but Dave Lawson is still here and a key member of our staff. What was your other ones? No change on Alexis Johnson. And George Bullock, yes, he's graduated and he's moving on to the next phase in his life. And we're very thankful to him, and we're going to help him every way we can.
Thank you, guys.
All right, thank you.